Hello, this is the Vikstrand coming to you again from a wintry Sweden. I'm standing right now on a frozen lake. And that has nothing to do with the movie I'm going to review today, because today I'm going to review a movie called Another Stakeout. The closest connection a frozen lake has to Another Stakeout is probably that the climax takes place around a swimming pool. And that's about it. So without any further ado, let's take a look at Another Stakeout. So we have a big mafia trial going on, and the star witness is being protected in a safe house. Unfortunately, the safe house goes 50 shades of boom. So agents have been killed and buildings have gone boom, but the witness is alive. But she has gone underground and they cannot find her. So our favorite two detectives, not those guys. No, not those guys either. There you go, there you go. So Bill and Chris, Richard Dreyfuss and Emilia Estevez is of course tasked to do another stakeout. This time they will not be alone, however, in the house. They will be accompanied by Gina, a district attorney played by Rosie O'Donnell. And surprise, surprise, they have a little problem getting along. They're two man-childs and one very pesky smartass. They're also going to pretend that they're a family. They are situated in a house which looks over the house where they think they're gonna show up. This is in a resort vacation type of community. And now we have a movie. Now the first thing that you should probably ask yourself is, how is this movie compared to a stakeout? For me, this is kind of weird. I saw this movie before I saw the original, and when I saw the original I expected that movie to be a lot better than this one, but it wasn't. They're on par. They're both very good entertaining movies, but they have different approaches. First movie, for obvious reasons, did have more romance. This one I think had more comedy in it. And the thriller element was also more present in the first one than in this one, even though this movie has a lot of suspense to it. Well, not a lot, maybe, but come on. So the jokes are good and they play off each other very well. I mean, Emilia Estevez and Richard Dreyfuss already had a good chemistry in the first one. And actually, Rosie O'Donnell works. She brings a lot to the table, a lot more than I would have expected. She's funny, she's feisty, and she has some seriously good punchlines. Not enough to be the 90s version of Melissa McCarthy, but beggars can't be choosers when it's come to Rosie O'Donnell, when she puts on what maybe is her best performance ever. In 1 year, she will, however, disgrace our screens as Betty. Ugh. This is a movie filled with light-hearted comedy and some light-hearted action. It is a movie that feels very safe to watch. You knew nothing too bad is going to happen and nothing too spectacular is going to happen, but you're gonna have a good time anyway because the script is funny. It is the story, in my opinion, actually is better than the original one, and the focus I think lies more on the stakeout than it was in the first one, where, you know, Dreyfuss and that lady, I cannot remember her name right now, but never mind about that. The jokes might have been better in the first one, but I think the story is better in this one. So there you go. They're good, but on different sort of level. The best jokes from the first one cannot be matched in this one, but they also have a better pacing in this one, so we don't get this very slow moment that we sort of, I think, we had in the first one. So if the first movie went a little bit like this, then this movie goes a little bit like this, so it is a bit smoother. There are some cliches in this movie, but they don't bother me that much. This is sort of a movie that you can see, that you sort of can ease back and say, yes, this will be a nice movie. I would have liked to see a little bit more what was going on with the mafia and stuff like that. That could have been, you know, funny. But most of our focus is on our three main characters, and that's fine, I guess. If you're looking for an action comedy, you're not going to get it here, because the action sequence that sort of exists, sort of, isn't exactly, you know, explosive and spectacular. But the suspense is surprisingly suspenseful. If you have never seen any of the Stakeout movies, I would recommend seeing both. They're both very good. If you've seen the first Stakeout movie but not this one, I would recommend you to see it because I think it's kind of good. If you don't like buddy cop movies and absolutely hate these kinds of movies, you're not gonna like this one either. This movie is funny, it is well made, it has good actors, it has good chemistry, and it has some seriously good lines. It isn't, you know, that memorable of a movie, but for what it is, I absolutely do not regret seeing it. It's a good movie. This movie gets a solid 66. It is easily digested, but on the other hand, it's very entertaining. This is the coldest day so far in the winter edition. It's about minus 10 today, and finally we have some sun. The sun shines in my eyes, however, today, so it's a bit difficult to maintain eye contact with the camera with both eyes open, but never mind about that. We'll see how much longer we can do this. It's the end of February, so I mean, we don't necessarily have that many more snowy days. Until next time, this is the Wikstrand signing out.